We're going to have a conversation basically about where the incident that took place in Iowa, so West Wargon, needs to be taken through. Because now we have the parliamentary candidate for the NDC, John Dumelo, now petitioning the office of the special prosecutor to move the matter forward and subsequently asking for investigations to be undertaken following that incident. And clearly, we'll bring you up to speed with the incident in itself. The pictures will be on the screen for you, where those who were participating in the special voting, predominantly those who are in the security services, were eagerly collecting food packages or items, and then also were also being given. So this is what has been addressed to the special prosecutor in that petition by John Dumelo's team, led by his legal practitioner, indicating that the incident happened, the time it happened. And so they have several recordings of Madam Lydia Alhassan, Sayram Alhassan, and her followers handling the plastic bags to the voters, and also attached the complaint to it as well, and subsequently asking for the intervention, maybe not investigations by the OSP. But this is how Lydia Alhassan, the Member of Parliament for Iowa West Wargon herself, reacted to the incident when she was questioned at the time.
They are always trying to attack me. They always do this, and here I am. By the grace of God, I have the temperament that is able to contain all of this. So they do all these, and I am the leader that I am.
Well, Lina, she said she was not at the incident site. And then later, the videos, and you know, for example, there was one media house that actually put an interview and then also the incident video there, where she was in there, blue cap, etc. I mean, clearly, we just told you what is in PNDC Law 284, flouting regulation. We know that all the parties have been engaged in sharing of items. It could be money, giftings, etc. I've seen cloths, I've seen chicken, rice bags, cooking oil all around. Happens not only in this election, has been happening, but where people are in the queue and you're distributing items, that clearly is treating or facilitating. Nobody can mince words about it. But of course, the OSP will have to undertake their work. What does it mean? This is a very important time for us to speak about this very incident. And within the corridors of power, the DMB campaign, what's the official position?
Thank you very much, Roland. I have seen the videos and some of the commentary that's run on the subject. And I've seen that the Dumelo campaign team has reported it to the Office of the Special Prosecutor, which I believe it is the appropriate thing to do when you have any grievance bordering this nature. So I think that it is right. They have the right and freedom to, as it were, report the matter to the Office of the Special Prosecutor. At the Office of DMB, I think that we have a campaign to run, and then we are focused on the campaign. We leave the OSP and the Electoral Commission to do their jobs. I personally have had this personal opinion that I do not think it is right for a ruling government to consistently, or a ruling party to consistently be defensive of the EC. That's my personal opinion. It creates a trust deficit. And I also believe that it is also wrong for an opposition to be consistently attacking the EC. It also creates another atmosphere of hostility, which I believe is not very good. The Ghana's laws are very clear on matters bordering of this nature. So the OSP has a mandate, and I'd like that we allow the OSP work. My worry is that the young man who signed the petition, Benjamin Avonyoche, well, I call him M16. He's a very good friend of mine. My worry is that this young man, or the Dumelo campaign team, has been around since 2020. Yesterday, I saw a video of a story by a sister station with John Dumelo also sharing some stuff during 2020 special voting. And my leader also doing the same. It creates a little bit of worry for me. Let me tell you why it creates a little bit of worry for me. That John Dumelo, same John Dumelo, who's crying foul, has been consistent about sharing items and things to voters, every single time. And it has been recorded over and over again with a media story on the subject in a queue in 2020. And in 2024, he turns around to cry foul on same subject. I believe that that is where I have a problem. So whereas crime has no expiry date, I believe that it is also right that the OSP avert its mind to the issue of same that happened in 2020. I don't have a problem whatever the outcome of the investigation goes. I believe that that is the mandate of the OSP, and that mandate should be allowed to work. Now, the exact problem, why I say that it is a problem that today, John Dumelo and the NDC have found their voices of complaint. And Richard, my good brother, knows what I'm talking about. That over the last couple of months, there's been a consistent pretext, by the NDC to create an atmosphere that does not augur well for this election. And I'll take you through why I believe strongly that this is very wrong in its nature. On the same day of the special voting, it happened as though it was a connected activity. In West, Upper West, we had complaints from the NDC. In Ashanti, complaints from the NDC by Hilda. In Ayawaso Central, John Dumelo. In Akando's constituency, Akando is complaining. Everyone seems to have become a complainant in the NDC. And it is a strategy, it's a grand strategy to create an issue where there are no issues. That's my belief. And to find excuses for an impending defeat that is staring so glare in their faces. And that is how come it has become very clear that the NDC is inconsistent on their position when it comes to the Electoral Commission. So if you want to understand this very well, let's just look at the position of John Dramani Mahama prior to 2016 election. John Dramani Mahama, in a statement, a newspaper publication by Ghana Web, says, allow East to work. John Mahama tells LMVC.
But the subject we're discussing is about the EC. No, please. The strategy you brought this morning.
Roland, it's not a strategy. It's a strategy maybe you have. I don't have a strategy.
The strategy you brought this morning is to create a scenario that there's a perceived complaint by the opposition party, that is the NDC, on special voting. Indeed, all the parties have been complaining since I started covering election. For my first election I covered as an intern was in the year 2000. And for this specific event, So the preface to the question I asked you was mm-hmm. that indeed there are videos online. Mm-hmm. I have even seen NDC members collecting chicken, and I've stated that. Mm-hmm. I've seen cloths being taken supposedly by MPP members, etc., with T-shirts of DMB in it. And I have also stated clearly that repleted on social media, especially on TikTok, are videos of the parties, their candidates, their assigns, sharing either it is money being displayed, either it is bags of an item or food being carried by party members, etc. We are speaking to this very specific incident in the 2024 special voting that took place in Ayawaso West Wogon, to the point that the candidate has now even petitioned the OSP. And so if you want to, if I had wanted to have a subject of monetization, etc., there's monetization in our politics. So what I'm asking you, is it that you want to go the broader way or you want to limit yourself in the scope? Because I want us to limit ourselves to the scope.
Roland.
Do you think that the regulation was flouted or not?
Roland.
Do you think that the member of parliament, the parliamentary candidate, should have behaved the way he did?
Roland, you've asked the question. I've given you my opinion. My opinion and your subject, the scope, we will limit it to your scope. Your scope borders on legality because a reportage has been made to the OSP. You cannot decouple my facts and my points that crime has no expiry date.
Then it's the two are not coterminous. The two are not coterminous.
And it cannot would you allow me, Roland?
The two are not coterminous.
You seem to be
interjecting me. Please speak on the specific subject.
No, Roland,
and I think that, with all due respect, speak on the specific subject.
With all due respect.
The incident that took place in Ayawas was over. Please limit your scope to that incident. And let's speak to that next level.
Roland, won't you allow me?
No.
You won't.
If you will not respond the way
the way you want.
No,
Roland,
no, no.
I did not dress, come.
No, please.
Roland, go to 1992, go to 2000. I did not wake up, dress, and come to respond to it the way that would make you feel good.
We have a specific subject.
I am dealing with a specific subject.
So deal with it
and
the way
it
has to be.
It is never wrong, Roland. It is never wrong to refer to precedents and history in dealing and dealing with the matter.
That is true.
Especially
this,
when, Roland, at least for a minute, two days ago. Roland, at least for a minute, you invited me here. Let me express my opinion.
Yes, you are expressing your opinion.
And then when you ask a question, allow me explain my point.
And I'm allowing you,
based on
a question I'm asking.
No, you are not.
No,
and
I
you,
am.
And you go on to
go
tell
ahead.
Me,
hold
go
on, ahead.
Hold on. Let me deal with it. And you go on to tell me you will not allow me if I don't answer in the way
because I
asked
a specific question.
And I am saying that you set the questions, I answer. The marking scheme is not with you.
No.
It's with our viewers.
I have never set a marking scheme. And
so
I've
allow me.
Go ahead.
Good.
And I'm saying that I asked a specific question.
You allow me and then you come in again.
No, because this is specifically an incident that happened.
Roland, I don't have a problem when you come in with your questions. So that is why I keep quiet and I listen. But when I am explaining and you decide to make it a business of not allowing me, it becomes a problem to me. So please do allow me.
I have allowed you.
Thank you. So what I'm saying is that once it borders on reportage to the OSP, it is not wrong that I also call on the OSP, whereas my opinion is that the OSP should investigate. I have stated my opinion. Clearly, I do not hold the final verdict of what OSP will investigate. But I also believe that crimes do not have expiry date. So whereas the OSP investigates it, it is right that you and I avert the minds of the OSP to other similar incident. And one critical example is election 2020, special voting, John Dumelo sharing items
in
the
queue. You have the video?
Yes, I will show you the video and the news item reported by UTV. I've even cited it. So let me continue. I've dealt with it. Now I draw your attention and the attention of viewers that, Roland, it is a problem when the opposition, I initially stated that I believe that the government or ruling party must not also have the penchant of defending. That one you didn't talk. Now I add on to say that I believe it is also wrong, create an atmosphere of hostility, that the NDC consistently becomes a complainant factory where they are always complaining, especially when the issues are very, very simple and straightforward to deal with. I have cited Akandos' complaint about a supposed transfer of the police commander. How is that consequential to the running of a smooth election when another police officer has been transferred? I have cited another one in Ashanti region where the NDC complained bitterly about Ashanti regional special voting without adducing a single evidence. I have also cited another one in Upper West where the NDC again complained. It is becoming one too many. And that is my point. And I come to buttress it with my opinion that John Dramani Mahama has been inconsistent about his opinion about the work of our electoral space. And that has transcended into the posture by the NDC in the entire election space. And that is where I
John,
draw the line.
Those complaints, is it about the electoral
cited,
commission?
Yeah, the EC cited.
No, I'm asking you a specific question. Is John Dumelo's complaint about the electoral commission
is the
or
EC
an
cited?
Action, or an, on an action that has been taken by a parliamentary candidate
Roland,
in the constituency
Roland,
he's contesting
he
in.
Cited the parliamentary candidate. He cited the EC. And he cited the security team there. So you do not pick and choose which one I deal with. If I decide to deal with, and I've dealt with my Lydia situation, and I've said that I reserve that to the OSP. I do not have the mandate to go and do OSP's work. Once it has been reported, I leave that to it. Now I have also my opinion on the EC's part. And my opinion is that the NDC must not become a complainant factory in this election. You do not approach an election in that way. And you see, it has a broader implication. It has a broader implication because it borders on our peace and the emotional stability of NDC members. And this is why it becomes even more dangerous. We cannot take the emotions of our party members for granted. MPP cannot do that, and the NDC cannot do that. Consistently, when the NDC has no strategy in an election, they become a complainant factory. complain, set a pretext to an election they are clearly going to lose. And that is why I have a problem. And that's why I draw the line. And that is where, if you're a young person and you're watching me today, you must be very, very wary and careful who you're going to cast your vote for. Because if you're an NDC member and your party's campaign machinery cannot manage a campaign in the face of all the challenges, then how do you expect someone like me to believe that same party that it can manage a country? And why do I say that the NDC struggles to manage its own campaign and resort to nothing but complaint? It's been 8 years in opposition, and there's never been a time they've been consistent in messaging. Every time the NDC comes out with a message, Sammy Jenfi's inability to manage his communications quarters very well leads to duplicity and inconsistency in the messaging. You pick their promises, and every time there are so many plethora, different and diverse ways of communicating it. They pick the issue of first year's free academic, and then one breath it is student loan. One breath they talk about technical universities not being part. In another breath they apologize. You come to 24 economy, in one breath it's Wache at 2 a.m. In one breath it is banking at 2 a.m.
You have a minute.
Consistently, the NDC lacks the understanding of managing their own political party. And then it makes me very clear in my mind that the NDC will struggle to manage Ghana. So if you're a young person and you are listening to me today, you should look at the posture of the NDC in managing their elections and their party. And the failure that after 8 years, they only come back to tell Ghanaians that it is banking at 2 a.m. that they offer to the people of this country. And that is why I believe that Roland and yourself and every well-meaning Ghanaian should be worried and ensure that come December 7th, we vote for bold solutions. Bold solutions that ensures that we protect Agenda 111. Bold solutions that ensure that we protect free senior high school. Bold solutions that ensures that we protect one district, one factory. Bold solutions that ensures that drone delivery services of medical supplies in this country is protected and secured. Thank you very much, Roland.
Clearly, regulations flouted. What you saw in the paper, can we have those videos come in where they're sharing the food and you get to find out that the candidate and then the member of parliament herself says, well, she wasn't even there. And at the end of the day, the videos also do indicate the women's organizer or the constituency or whatever, and she's rightly there. And she says, well, they give food freely, but this cannot be the norm, can it be? Richard.
Roland, well, let me say good morning to you and good morning to our viewers and good morning to His Excellency, the incoming President of the Republic of Ghana, John Dramani Mahama, and the good people of Nkwanta South Constituency and Oti region as a whole. Roland, listening to my brother Dennis, I have, you know, viewed that as a journalist myself who understand the concept of media and visual communication. I take things very serious and analyze issues before the content, any content I want to bring out there, I filter it very well. Because I know the implication of mis and disinformation, which if you are not careful, I've always said that misinformation is dangerous than HIV AIDS.
What's your point?
So my point is that anything you want to say, you should be careful. 3 days to elections. These are critical issues we must take notice of. And these are issues that will strengthen our democracy. You ask him of the incidents in Iowa, so West Wagon. What did he say? He said, for them as a political party, they don't care what happens.
Yeah, please
take they don't mind what happened. They are only focusing on winning elections, and that is the MPP for you. So if you have a flag bearer and a campaign team that flout a PNDC law 284 in this country, and a citizen and a parliamentary candidate has gone to special prosecutor to report such a corrupt incident to a special prosecutor. I think as young as we are, we should be sitting here thinking about how we'll be able to protect the integrity of our democracy. We should think of how we should be able to weigh and have confidence as which leader and what leader will choose at what time. Lydia and what he has done and what I saw, I have always termed this lady to be very undemocratic. It's an allergic to our democracy. And that has always been a problem. What is it about her? That any time Lydia wants to contest any elections in this country, it's either it might be chaos, it's either about flouting of the rules in this country, or it's either that he doesn't even take democracy into consideration. You remember what happened at Yawasi Wasogo under the care of Lydia Alhassan. And that people were gunned down, people were seized not to vote in this country. The NDC have to withdraw from that election to make sure she has gone through that parliamentary proceeding illegally. Because our parliamentary candidate was not even allowed to come out to vote. And you saw what happened. Blood was shed. Members of parliament were beaten up. We talked about it. What did President Adamu Akufo-Addo do? When a short commission came out with a reprimand Michael Opoku, the then Kenny Opoku, was even promoted to Brigadier General in this country. And we raised such concern about that. This incident happened in Ayawaso, was gone. Recently, a University of Ghana, at the gate, she went there, bribed the security officer.
She said that she's...
What are you saying? We saw the security officer come out.
Yes.
She went there,
but her
bribed...
Her response was that she has no...
Listen, I am telling you, she went
no
there... That's what she does
and
in that person. What are you saying? You saw what happened on the video, where she's talking to electorate, direct online. Security officers, people with reputation, people that who can trust. Look, if Lydia Alhassan can go in and bribe security officers to vote for him, what happened to the Nandorangwa and Baomia? What will happen with the credibility of our elections? If they equally go and bribe people to do that, do you think this nation will be in a peaceful country during this election? At the University of Ghana, she was bribing a security officer with rice and mackerel to vote for her. The security officer came out and said she gave millions of people around the area with those bribes. Hundreds of people around that. And that's typical of her. We raised an alarm, spoke about it, nobody cares about
but
it.
Richard,
when
it comes to giving items,
yes,
prior to the election, and what we've seen, all the parties do, including the NDC.
Empirically, listen, we all know we campaign, we go out there to campaign and share people transportation, and all that, but not when electors are on a queue. It is purely illegal, and she must be prosecuted with immediate effect. This is a very serious issue that we should look at. I have always said, look at what actually happened. I have always said, the MPP behaved. Roland, you remember when we were in primary four, I happened to attend Bunache LA primary. In primary four, they taught the cock and the hen story.
Attended which school?
Bunache LA primary school.
Bunache?
Yes, in Nkwantasa. I attended a local authority. Yes, a local authority. I remember my teacher in class four taught me about Ketekre Soya. You remember the hawk and the hen story? That's the critical and empirical. That's how they behave.
Junior secondary school. Like.
Absolutely.
Ketekre Soya. What has that got to do
so
with the
So, it's the hawk and the hen. They'll go and commit crime because they are lazy. They will not put in effort. As NDC is going out selling the 24-hour economy policy that millions of Ghanaians are buying into, as NDC goes out and talk about national apprenticeship program and Ghanaians are buying into, as the NDC is telling the Ghanaians that we're going to build six new universities and it's going to be based on technical and vocational-based universities, and Ghanaians are buying into the ideas, our mothers are buying into the ideas that the Women Development Bank will give an equity in poverty alleviation into their business centers, and our mothers are buying into it. The big push project is coming. The policies and programs we are bringing, and Ghanaians are overwhelmingly trying to vote for us. They turn around the money they stole because they are lazy, they couldn't perform. The money they stole, they come to give to the people to vote. We must receive this kind of act of vote buying under this government. And my worry is that one thing about the MPP, they are very good at distributing items in this country.
But
you recall,
also distribute
no,
items.
You recall, just of, in Sala, Baomia went and distributed expired rice. We complained about it. You recall, in this country, the MPP and themselves distributed boss scandal, distributed oil, contaminated oil among themselves. We complain about it. You recall, in this country, they themselves distributed galamsey site for themselves. We complain about it. All this time, instead of you delivering the Ghanaian people from poverty, instead of you delivering Ghanaian people of bad water, bad road, bad economy, you clearly want to buy the conscience of an individual to vote. And what one thing that I get scared is that, In the situation in which we are going through now, where people cannot pay their rent, where people cannot buy food to eat, where people cannot pay transportation, where people cannot buy fuel, if you go to rich hospitals, people are lying on bed.
So you're
and
calling
you have
for the
somebody,
prosecution of...
Absolutely.
Well,
and,
no
you,
OSP
and,
will have
and,
to do that.
And you have the guts to go and buy people's conscience for them to get power again. It will never be good for our democracy in this country when MPP have a way to buy food and win this election. And that is why all of us must protect the integrity of our democracy. And for that, President Mahama is very, very worried of this act. And I can assure you, in some few days, we'll be in government. If a special prosecutor didn't even take this seriously, when we win power and take over power, we will prosecute this incident of any corrupt act that happened in this country. And that's what President Mahama talks about.
Solo, the incident, even the videos already we've sent of all the parties, and they need, ideally, to have made sure that the parliamentary candidate, who also apparently doubles also as a member of parliament, doesn't go to the extent of either making sure that, well, giftings are given to people in the queue to vote. I mean, that's just a meter or two away.
Roland, my difficulty this morning is how we abuse the name of God in this country. You see, listening to the ease with which she referred to God, I think God has to have a lawyer on it to be able to deal with such misconduct.
God needs to have a lawyer on it?
Because we are abusing the name. They go and commit crime. Interestingly, she was wearing white. You remember Ken Ofureta? He would go and wear white, quote Bible, and come and dissipate her revenue. The same with Lydia Alhassan. Go and mention the name of God, yet you have committed a crime. My worry also is that the indiscretion exhibited by the security service personnel. Indiscretion, lack of discretion. Because my checks reveals that the food Lydia Alhassan served is from the Moshosho rice infested with maggots and so on.
You can't make
No, I have done a lot of extensive research on whatever has happened. Apparently, the Moshosho expired rice, they left some for this election. And it's not just...
You mean rebagged?
Rebagged. They are going to use it to cook for a number of voters across the length and breadth of this country. So I would want to call on all those that took the Moshosho rice to first of all, as a matter of urgency, visit any nearby hospital to go through a laboratory test.
So because you can't be saying that.
I can be saying that because this woman wants to kill. This woman wants to injectify people with Moshosho infested rice. Either than that, why would she have done that? Why would she? If you believe you have done a good job, that is so much clear for everyone to see. You don't need to be there to be sharing rice to police officers, security, prison officers, and so on and so forth. Who watches the watchman? The people that are supposed to watch us come December 7th themselves have been compromised. Daylight. But I'm not interested in whether or not the OSP will be able to deal with this matter. Because you remember, as far back as August of 28th of August, together with my running mate, we petitioned the OSP on a similar situation, food matter. You remember all the All-Africa games? When this government, the Minister of Youth and Sports, used $15 million to cook wache for sportsmen.
No food.
But is wache not a food? I have inquired. They cooked only wache for $15 million. He is yet to even revert back to us. And this is also food that we are talking about. It is a way and manner the new patriotic party thinks they can make any meaningful impact in this election. That is bribing the conscience of the electorate. And it didn't end there. You see, places like Bekwai, a police officer who put out her number instructing fellow officers to go and vote for the MPP. It's all there. You go to Ofinso.
On the special day.
On the special day. Ofinso, police officers being given Momo, 150 cities, 200 cities, to go and vote for a particular. I want to plead with all the telcos that for the sake of the unity of this country, the sanctity of this election, on 7 December, they must disable their mobile platforms.
Well, what's going to happen?
Because the MPP is going to share money through mobile money.
No,
I'm telling you. But it has already happened during the special voting. They want to buy the conscience of the people of this country. And why must it be so? And those of you who are interested in taking this money, let me assure you that these people are not entrepreneurs. They are not businessmen. It is your own money. It is our tax meant to construct or develop our hospitals that they want to share. They have stolen it. And that is why you have all these deficits. Either than that, why would a member of parliament being caught on tape? And you see, my brother, younger brother Dennis, together with the communicators of the MPP.
Please, let's not get personal. Dennis is a very independent minded man.
It's a friendly advice. I have to. And as well as all the political parties, one of the legacies that our forebears have left to political communicators is to lie. You know, even when they are caught, then they want to openly lie. Yesterday, I listened to another gentleman who says he's a special aide to Madame Lydia Alhassan on radio, telling us that there is no video that is depicting Madame Lydia Alhassan giving out goodies. And I thought I was in Azerbaijan, not in Ghana. Because how can I see something that is so glaring like that for someone to tell me it never happened? You see, when you speak truth, it can even get you votes. You get my point? When the thing is white, it is white. This business of trying to draw in the electoral commission, the other party, it will not wash. The issue is that the woman has erred, but she will get away with it because this is the party that is in government and that has appointed people to mind various positions. That will not be able to take on their own. It will never happen. Unless there is a change of government that will come in with that mentality to deal with all manner of people.
Now that the issue is with the OSP and all that, you seem to have expressed distrust for the OSP.
Oh, I don't trust
the
OSP.
So where should we go?
So what is going to happen is that we have to change this government, bring in Alan Chemantin. Alan has promised to respect the laws of this country. Let me tell you, this Lydia
Alhassan... I was speaking in relation to this specific incident. You brought Alan Chemantin.
The matter has been reported. Crime has no expiry date. Alan comes in, there will be a czar, a corruption czar, anti-corruption czar, who is so independent-minded, who moves swiftly. Not just this matter. All other matters are related to corruption that this government is sitting on it will be dealt with. And did I hear him say, we must vote for both solutions and what? Which both solution? The only both solution, Dr. Mahmoud Bawumia told the country, is that when he comes, he will make national service non-compulsory. That is the only bold solution he has told us. Making national service non-compulsory, how does it solve our unemployment situation? How does it solve people who are not getting food to eat? How does it solve our deplorable nature of our roads? How does it solve unemployment, jobs and jobs? The only man capable of doing that is the one who has given you the great transformation plan that is promising you more jobs through diversified economy.
Now let's get some legal perspective on this. Martin Pebu is a legal practitioner. He's joining us. Martin Pebble, good morning to you. You take a look at what the PNDC law 284 does indicate in 33, 34 specifically, and the actions that need to be taken. Even you take a look at the personnel who were beneficiaries of this, largely among them security personnel, going to man, guide people, and this seems a behavior, if it becomes a trend in the main election, we're in trouble. Now, subsequently, how ideally should the state actors be acting, the quasi-state institutions?
Yeah, so we have to ramp up education, Roland. Yes, let's ramp up education today, tomorrow, and Friday. That is against the law, as you rightly quoted, right? To either accept money, or that's a bribery provision, section 32, okay, or to collect food, drinks, entertainment, and other provisions. So let's increase education, because at times past, I'm aware that in the police service, they usually try to give their officers some education. I'm not aware if it's taking place this year. If it is, they can put it on air. Because when they do, then they empower the masses to be able to draw the police attention to such infractions. If anybody finds at the polling station that food is being given to a police officer, okay? And the same for the prison officers who were seen in this case. So I think education is very key, because let's not wait and use the law as a trap. Because it's possible, you know, every year they recruit policemen. Every year they recruit prison officers, generally. So it's possible those who have been recruited don't know the law. So let's increase the education. Because if we do all the education, and yet on Saturday we find people collecting these foods and money, etc., then we'll prosecute them swiftly. But, you know, because the law is very vast, even as a lawyer, I cannot know every law on this in Ghana. For me, I think education is the right way to start, so that by Saturday, if people are still causing infractions, then we'll prosecute them. And also, it's not just education on the mass and electronic media, but let's also use the information vans. I know there are not too many, but we can rope in GPRTU. Government can hire some of the smaller GPRTU buses, etc., or this is small cars, like the saloon cars, to put in PA systems, etc., to do the education in the various communities, especially in the rural areas.
Okay. So for this very specific matter, we know there's a matter before the OSP, etc. What actions need to be taken quickly, knowing that we just have about 2 or 3 days to this major election by the institutions of state?
Yeah, so number one, OSP needs to come out with an update on Professor Nyako's case. You remember in the by-election, Professor Nyako is an MP for Kwadrasu, MPP.
All right. Dennis, so internally, how is the party going to deal with this, or the campaign?
Well, Roland, I mentioned earlier that I believe that once the matter has been sent to the OSP, we'll leave it there. But before I get into that, I'll take a minute to deal with some of the issues raised by Richard. Richard mentioned sharing of rice and mackerel, and then he was consistent about sharing. MPP is buying, is going to buy vote. This is Okan Chris out.
I've seen this one.
Chicken. And what hurts me is that it wasn't in Kokong Keteng Keteng. This way, in Kokong Keteng Keteng. So for some people, you give them in Kokong Keteng Keteng. Some you give them in Kokong Keteng. This is your PC. Richard, look at him. It's your PC. So when you come here, when you come here, you find your righteousness horses. Do not ride it too fast. Slow down. Now let us go to your cock and bull story. You talk about cock and hen story. Cricket soldier. Do you know what cricket soldier? We do an education on cricket soldier. This is cricket soldier one. Teacher training allowance won't be restored even if it costs me my elections. Cricket soldier one. Cricket soldier two. I will maintain allowance for teacher training nurses if I win 2020. This is cricket soldier one. Let's go on. Another cricket soldier. It is a bloody lie to blame COVID and Ukraine, Russia for economic crisis. This is Mahama, your flag bearer. Same Mahama. Mahama admits COVID-19 Russia Ukraine war destroyed African economies. Cricket soldier, cock and hen story. Another cricket soldier, I cannot promise a new stadium under current crisis. John Mahama. This is another cricket soldier. Same John Mahama. Mahama promises stadia in all regions. This is not even a cock and hen story. This is antelope and crocodile story. Same cricket soldier. If you have 2 billion more to spend on education, would you spend it all on free SHS? John Mahama, cricket soldier one. Another cricket soldier. We will include private schools in free SHS program. Cricket soldier. Last cricket soldier, then we move on. Agenda 111 is overly ambitious and not realistic. Your flag bearer, Richard. And he says NDC will complete Agenda 111 in Nigeria. So when you come here and you attempt to tell Ghanaians a story, do not find a story that makes you the worst of anything. Your flag bearer is the embodiment of inconsistencies, embodiment of double-tongued, embodiment of policy and credibility deficits. He's never been able to stand on one place, and that is why you and the NDC will lose this election, because the Ghanaian people watching me today have valued and weighed the NDC. And they've come to the realization that the consistency is not there. Today it is 2 a.m. banking, tomorrow it is another story. There is no consistency. And that is why today I beg the young people watching me, that I beg you in the name of God, when you are going to vote, vote for someone who finds a problem and finds a solution to it. Dr. Mahmoud Bawumia finds a problem in cost of transportation, and says that one of the ways of ensuring that cost of transportation comes down is to eliminate the fuel aspect of cost of transportation by bringing in electric vehicles. That is solution-driven. Dr. Mahmoud Bawumia finds a problem with the premix buying in the coastal areas with the way they move their canoes to fish. Then he brings solar-powered outboard motors to power the canoes and the fishing vehicles. It tells you that he is solving a problem. Dr. Mahmoud Bawumia finds a problem in our health infrastructure deficit, and he proposes Agenda 111. At the end of the day, that is someone who finds a solution. So, Roland, you want me to speak to your question? I've spoken to your question. leave OSP to it. When he finds out, whatever he finds, me and the MPP, I can assure you, Dr. Mahmoud Bamiyan would respect it. But as to the issue of cricketer soldier and all the things that Richard, my good friend, came to sit here to blab about, we have demonstrated over and over that his flag bearer is an embodiment of inconsistency, an embodiment of double-tongued, an embodiment of credibility deficit, an embodiment of someone who has not been able to, after 8 years, tell Ghanaians what his solutions would be and how he's going to execute what he wants to execute. Dr. Mahmoud Bamiyan has been clear in what he wants to do for this the people of this country. He's been clear about the continuation of Agenda 111. And why do I trust Dr. Mahmoud Bamiyan? Because he's the vision bearer. Today and tomorrow, Nana Addoudan Kwaku Fuad is commissioning 6 hospitals. 6 in 2 days. 6. He's commissioning Okere, Jumapo, and then Kwadin today. Today. And the good thing about Dr. Nana Addoudan Kwaku Fuad is that if he commissions, we use. Trede, Kokobin, and Bokro are tomorrow. The forward march of this country is clear. Dr. Mahmoud Bamiyan has been consistent and been very, very credible about his policy proposals. My brother, on his research, I will not really worry myself, because if he had any credible research, he should have provided it to his candidate, Alan, in order to help him win flag bearer and not cry out and run away from a flag bearer race. So at the end of the day, Roland, I appreciate that you've been able to do this.
Okay, Mr. Martin Kwebu.
Uh-huh.
So I asked the question before you went off and had that interference. What should be done, knowing that we already have this captured on tape and the responses thereof of the Member of Parliament and the parliamentary candidate in respect of the incident 2 days ago in Ayawaso, West Wagon, apart from just petitioning OSP?
Okay, yes. So I mentioned that, okay, maybe it didn't come through. You see, there was a similar case of Professor Nyako, the MPP MP for Kwadaso, right, who gave money to an electoral officer in the by-election. So I'm expecting OSC to come out with that and the update on that case, that they are going to court or whichever state they bring. Because then that will give us confidence that, yes, this one too, they can do something about it. Because once Professor Nyaku's case is not seen where it is headed for, we cannot be sure Lydia's case will go any better. So, first in, first out, let's hear from the OSP. Roland, you remember the Professor Nyaku matter, the one guy who was caught on camera giving money to the EC official?
Yes, the envelope.
Yes. It was taken to the OSP. It's been how many months? It's over 4 months. Did not have anything. So OSP needs to give an update on that and give it massive media traction so that it will boost confidence that, okay, if Nyaku is headed for court, then Lydia Alhassan too will be headed for court. Okay, so that's the first thing. Then, number two, it will give us an update on the Lydia Alhassan case. It's true that by the OSP law, they give two updates in a year. That's every 6 months. But since this case is a special one, very, very proximate to the election, they can make an exception because the law is saying that they should do it twice. It doesn't matter if you can do 3 times. Because if they're able to give us an update, it will also send a big caution to the voting populace that, hey, even an MP, that a second MP is also going to face court.
Right.
Okay, or whatever, or the investigations are at peace. So these two cases put together will send a strong signal to the populace, and especially as these two MPs belong to the ruling government. They are both MPP MPs. So then people will see that, okay, if OSC can deal with people who are even part of the government, hey, then Charlie, if you are an ordinary citizen, you will be careful.
Okay.
But if you don't get these two things done, the main opinion that is going around is, oh, nothing will happen. Because yesterday, did you hear, I followed Lydia's interview on CTFN. Oh, she was very calm. When Bernard was trying to point out to her that it's criminal, etc., she was saying, oh, let the law officers deal with it. Let the law enforcement people deal with it. Hey, very confident, you see? Aha, so let's see. Has she been invited? Oh, if she give us that update. Has she been cautioned? Has she written a statement yet?
All of that is very, very important. So to the OSC, and then like I mentioned earlier, general education for the masses as well.
Okay.
Because, you know, generally, as we increase education, we are likely to get more converts.
All right. Thank you very much for this interjection, and then also giving us this sort of education when it comes to what the law agencies should be doing. So, Richard, we're just 2 days, 3 days away. How do we make sure we don't have the experiences of what happened 2 days ago, and we don't have that sort of, I have to say, one-on-one interaction with a candidate on voting day, and also with the voters?
Roland, I think Denis sat here and made some allegations and brought some document from MPP printing house. MPP printing house. And I don't know how authentic it is. But I will. It's a public document. I think as it's here. I can equally respond to distance one by one. And Roland, let me tell you.
I come to
understand.
How do we make sure?
No, I come to understand the major problem of MPP is about thinking. And that's the reality. They lack capacity of thinking, and they always want, no, hold on, make up. And they always want to be politically cognitive. Richard, and that is what we must not allow. He sits here and use the NDC will complete agenda 111, agenda distance. What did President Mahama say? President Mahama has made it clear that as he's coming out with a big push project, and all the abandoned projects will be completed. Is it wrong to abandon projects that have not been completed? You, your government. There are so many projects President John Dramani Mahama has made, like e-blocks. Look, as I'm talking to you, the Kotoka International Airport there yesterday, they went and launched the e-gate, have not been commissioned as a sound now. You are aware? You have projects. You have not officially commissioned Kotoka International Airport, but you go there to commission e-gate. What kind of hypocrisy is that? President Mahama is saying that all the projects that have been abandoned, your president, Nana Addo Akufo-Addo, said he was overly ambitious about Agenda 111. Didn't he say that? And apologize to Ghanaians. Hey. And the president says, look, when I come to power, I have a big push project. I will definitely complete this project. And if you think that is, then that is total hypocrisy. If you don't know, let me tell you. You sit here and talk about what? That I will include private schools in free SHS. And President John Dramani Mahama says what? That he will send free SHS. President John Dramani Mahama, under him, said, look, free education, that he's not going to invest that much into it. He's saying clearly that, let us build infrastructure, let's build facilities before we're able to start. People have already been saying that. You have children that have attended this adult, people that have attended, have opportunity to present. I have attended Boyman's Inner High School. I didn't have that opportunity of being a disadvantage or whatever it is. I attended Boyman's Inner High School. The quality of education that I had then, you from Addis Ababa or what precinct, whatever, we have equal capacity of the reasoning. And that's what President Mahama is talking about. He's talking about building quality educational system. You put children in classroom 1 week ago, 2 weeks ago, and stay home. Is that education? That is what we are talking about. And President Mahama is saying that he's going to strengthen the free education and make sure that the capacity of building, getting classroom blocks, making sure the syllabus are there, make sure that the student doesn't go home and sit. And if you make this decision, if you mention all this, listen. Please stop. Look, the agenda 111 you are even talking and being proud of. The MPP agenda 111 is only 40 bed capacity. You are aware.
And
no, listen.
Agenda
what are you talking about?
Bed.
Look, the bed. No, listen.
That's a lie.
Listen, the list.
There's 40 beds
the
are
list,
different from the agenda 111.
The list President Mahama has done.
You are lying.
Go.
That one.
Please,
there.
Will you behave
if
yourself?
If Roland will allow you, lie.
No,
allow
no. Will you behave yourself?
You will not lie. Please.
Will you behave yourself?
Please. I'm behaving. Are you lying?
President Mahama. The list.
He says that there are categories that are.
Yes.
Are they also
agenda
part
one,
of?
One, one, not, it's not 40.
The 40 beds are not part.
They are not part of.
So
agenda
the main
one.
Hospital, for example, is
not. It's not.
It's not part of
yes.
Agenda.
So it's
so
part of what?
Are they?
No.
Which
one is part of?
Med project.
No. Listen.
See what we tell you. Don't really see. But med project.
No. Please stop this. Listen. I can equally misbehave like you. But I see,
okay.
I believe in decency.
So
at least,
people are watching us.
At least, if not for nothing at all, in social studies, there are no deviant behavior.
Oh.
And I think you must practice that. Please.
You are
so when you sit here and talk about things that you don't have vision of, President John Dramani Mahama has made clearly that in every situation that you have caused a mess in this country, you broke down the economy. And that's the main problem is to have to fix it. And we sit there, we'll tell you that we are bringing a 24-hour economy. That will create jobs for people. I have always asked you people. Atu Abuga that President Mahama has built, Atu Abuga, how many hour economy is it built?
Richard, you have a
economy.
Minute to wrap up.
So if you don't have vision, just stop it. Look, we are serious as a country. And in any case, you ask that what do we do in 2-3 days now?
To make sure.
Thankfully, the national security has given us. They say, if you see something, do what? You say something. Mm-hmm. And I think that is what we should take a critical look at. I will urge every Ghanaian that on Saturday, if you see any MPP member going paying bribe to people to go and vote, you have the right to even arrest him as a citizen and take him to police station. If you see any MPP trying to induce ordinary Ghanaian to make sure they vote, you must act swiftly, act fastly, so that we'll be able to get this. So I would want Ghanaians to go to vote on Saturday. If you go to the poll, you go with hunger. So if you get to the police station, you are hungry. If you go to the police station, you see there's no water for you. If you go to the police station and you see that your child has been in school for only 2 weeks and pay school fees and buy items more than the school fees and come back to stay home 3 weeks, you vote against the MPP. The MPP has no vision. When you ask them, what are they bringing to us? They say, and for them.
They have agenda one.
No, that's it. No, what did they say they're coming to do for us? What's bold solution? The bold solution is that you have brought e-levy. And he said, "You should vote for you when you win. You cancel e-levy. That's bold solution. The bold solution is that you have brought the betting tax, and you said we should vote for you when you win. You cancel the betting tax. That is bold solution. The bold solution is that you gave us an emission levy, and he said when we win, we should vote for you again. When we win, we will cancel. These are visionless solutions that you don't have. You don't have the capacity, the balls to run this country. I have called Dr. Bawumia. If I were to be a landlord, I would call me a very bad tenant." And a very ungrateful tenant. But Dr. Bahamia ran away and said, it's Mr. Digital. Roland, let me ask you something. I will finish with you. Roland, if you, Roland, build your house, you build a house, put every structure in place, and somebody come to rent the house and bring mattress, and bring this, you say you are the landlord. The digitalization is talking about. President John Dramani Mahama has built a Accra Digital Center, put all the digital structures in place. You are downloading apps, and that's what disgraced you at the airport. Even the airport, that's what disgraced you yesterday at the airport. You were doing e-gate. Instead of that, you put the facial recognition code in, pick your social. So I want to urge Ghanaians that on December 7th, when you go to the polls, your solution is in the hands of the NDC. Your solution is in the hands of President John Dramani Mahama. So we have done it before, and we'll certainly do it again.
Wrap up on this for me. Yeah, sure. 3 minutes. Sure. Uninterrupted.
Let me say that
he threw a dig at you. He says,
I'm going to go there because clearly the party MPP is worried that Alan is in this race. Oh. And it is because they themselves know that Ashanti region is gone. Alan will wrap up his campaign in Ashanti region. We will win massively in Ashanti region to the glory of Yahweh. All their machinations will end on Saturday. We know they are going to share money on Saturday, but the good people of Ashanti knows how many of them have entered into the poverty threshold. How many of the youth who are in Ashanti region are now unemployed. The hardship levels. This is what all these elections is about. And if you care to know, the only mandate of any president is to make sure the Ghanaian is happy, happy, and happy. Let me also say that I have heard an audio circulating that President Akufo-Addo attempts to endorse Alan Chemanti. We want to reject that endorsement in this last minute. The president must not attempt to bring any bad luck into this whole campaign that we have done beautifully to assure history. This business of go and vote for my ex-minister, we are not interested in that.
I'm sorry, no, we are solid.
Endorse your candidate, Bawumia, so that you go with him with the baggage. And I also want to say that the security agencies who have taken bribes in this special voting. If
you said they've been giving momos and things.
Momos, and they're ready more. So I have already appealed to the conscience of the telcos to block their platforms on election day. Please do this for the sake of peace. Do it for us. Don't let mobile money go.
Oh, and when
you go into the ballot, remember that as we speak, the turbidity levels of our water is still the 14,000 NTU, which is still killing. Now, the LI 2462 that the president allowed people to be mining in our forest is still there. Nothing has happened to it. His cronies are the ones mining, killing you. Remember that. Remember the woman that sold the newly born baby for only 300 cedis. That is the state of the economy. Remember that. Remember the Accra to Kumasi, that deplorable road. Those of you in Afienya, look at the traffic situation. I can't imagine that you will be in this traffic and on Saturday you will go and kill and vote for this incompetent. Mind you, under Article 42 of our Constitution, the Electoral Commission is supposed to register people with sound mind. Only reason why you must be of sound mind is that you can make a sound determination. I would be very surprised and would not forgive myself if indeed we threw the NDC out in 2016 when their inflation levels was 15.4 and today is 22%. Then if you go on that tangent and vote for this party called the New Patriotic Party, then you are not of sound mind. I don't want to believe that. My former party has misbehaved. So I left them willingly. I left the party. It's not a good party. And he was talking about Alan Chemante. If he was that good, he would have won. My research pointed to the fact that there were truthful people in the MPP, more than the greedy bastard ones that wanted Mr. Alan Chemante to be the flag bearer. But the I am that I am king that they call him the president. I am that I am. I want to do something that nobody has done. Cause them to go and bring every week. So weak a candidate. Mahmoud Bawumia is so weak a candidate.
But he won.
He won what?
He won the primary.
He won this primary. Okay, 7 December will determine whether or not indeed he won. We will show him Pepe and would understand the demography and the partisan nature of this country. I am my submission.
Well, thank you very much, Richard. And then also Solomon Owusu and Dennis